Hi, Joe Cerrone. Welcome to CAD 230 Intro to SolidWorks for, I'm not sure why it says spring 2021. It should be spring 2022. So there's a bit of a glitch there. I'll fix it when I get a minute. I've prepared a welcome introduction for you, a little bit about myself and some of the course basics. I basically will run this course every week with a Zoom meeting, and you don't have to attend it, but I just like to have a check on everybody to make sure they understand how the course is laying out. And I'll use this same link right here. And so you can join that meeting on Tuesdays at 10 a.m. or 6 p.m. This morning, I didn't have a big turnout, so we'll probably migrate to the later time towards 6 p.m. As we go through. But for the first couple of classes, I'll run two meetings just to get everything running. Attendance is not required. This is an asynchronous course. You can just do the work and turn it in, and that's fine. But if you do come to the Zoom meetings, you can get questions answered and maybe get a little bit more out of the course. You'll need a copy of the student version of the software or be able to access it somewhere. And so if you have it at work, you know, great. If you need a copy of it, you can download it from this website. They do charge $60. But $60 is really a bargain for this software. I mean, it's a very high-tech, very robust software, and I've installed it, and it comes with the CAM package as well. And so there's a number of add-ons that you get that are really terrific for the $60. And if it is really tight and you have some difficulty, you can spread it out over a monthly payment, or if it's really, really tight, you can email me and I can see if I can find some way for you to get the software also. So you will need to get the software, or you can VPN in, or you can go to one of the Oakton campuses to be able to complete the course. And so here it is right here. All right, back to the main splash page. And I'm gonna turn off my webcam. Textbook, SolidWorks 2021. If you click on this link right here, there it goes. And then you click on the purchase options. You can purchase it from Google Play, Apple Books, Amazon. I like the digital books a little bit more now because I can just look at them on my iPad. And so it's $52 for an ebook. You can buy it in the bookstore also. So if you have some kind of agreement with your company that says you have to buy it from the store, then we will sell it to you there. They typically charge a little bit more. So this is a pretty decent price. And then let's see, my icons keep disappearing on me for the D2L. All right, so that's the basic layout for the front page. I'll put in the calendar when things are due. And so typically 2 weeks from when we start, I'll have the first assignment due. This one looks a little pushed back. I've got to see what's going on with this. Because typically I would have the first assignment due in 2 weeks. So I may have a bit of a glitch, but the first module will be due in 2 weeks. This one says February 15th. So I have a glitch, I will fix it. All right, as we go through the course, the way I have it set up then is that we have the main page here. And the idea is that we wanna learn how to draw. We basically do a lot of CAD drawings. If we go to the content section, we can go through some of the basics here. So for example, if we look at the course syllabus and PDFs load faster in D2L, so I click on those. Course is CAD 230, Introduction to SolidWorks. My office is located in Skokie in room P131. If you click on this link, you can find out a little bit about me. I've got to update my webpage, but talked enough about myself already. There's no prerequisite. I like to let people register for the more advanced courses if they want to. And I'll tell them it's recommended, you know, that you have some general skills in computers and things like that. But I won't stop people from taking courses. I found some people can jump right in and do just fine. And we're going to basically go through SolidWorks parts modeling. And as we go through, we'll look at creating sketches. We'll do a lot of these engineering learning objectives, you know, concepts, working with other, you know, with part models. I do a lot of 3D print work. I also do machining with CNC. So I can wear a lot of hats, but essentially when you get down to it, I really want people who are good at SolidWorks. And I've been doing this for a long time. Some of the guys that I've trained from back when I taught high school, you know, are out at these companies now, and they're doing, you know, really good jobs with some of that. And so as you go through it, that's really the game that I like to, or that's really what I'm working towards, is getting people proficient. All right. Be sure to stay away from these academic integrity issues. They're no fun. Outline of topics. Okay. You know, we'll start off with the interface sketching, creating parts, creating assemblies. We'll have a midterm after module 7. And then we'll go through some of these other aspects, but essentially we follow the textbook. And so we'll cover the textbook as much as we can. We typically get into assembly drawings. And so that's toward the end of the course. Prepare to spend about 10 hours per week on your drawings. Some guys can do it in half of that or less than that. It just depends on how detailed you get into it and how much you work and whether or not you've got other responsibilities. You know, we all have other responsibilities, and, you know, if something comes up, you know, don't miss something that's really important. You can email me and ask for an extension, or you can, you know, ask for whatever you need. But from a standpoint of running the course and things like that, there is a significant amount of time that you want to spend getting good at working with the software. Takes some time. The way that the course is laid out here is the percentage. It's mostly lab work. Midterm and final exams are a big chunk from it. And then we have quizzes and these model quizzes. And I'll show you how those work as well. Grading scale is straight 90, 80, 70, 60. Most people do really well in the course. And, you know, I understand people are working and things like that. So if you do the work and you have things in on time, you shouldn't have a problem getting a B. It's tough to get an A. I'm not a big C or D type person. So, you know, do your best with it. But as we go through, that's kind of how the grading scale works out. You have to work really hard to get an A. If you have any learning disabilities or any issues or anything like that, there's a lot of support people at Oakton. And if you need somebody to talk to, you can always talk to me offline, and I can set you up to talk to somebody if you need some assistance with anything going on. And there can be some really crazy stuff out there, some really good counselors out there. So if you do need anything, feel free. That Oakton's a safe place to ask. The protocols, as far as COVID, that's kind of why we're all online, vaccination testing. I am open. I do go into the school and I do work, and I like it. You know, being at home is not really all that great all the time. And so I'm there Monday through Saturday, typically from 9 o'clock. I'm usually there 8:30 until 12 with my office hours, but I'm typically there till 10 o'clock at night when I teach courses in person. So you're welcome to come in, provided you pass the COVID protocols. So that's the syllabus and the outline of topics. Back to the main splash page. And we're at about 9 minutes. So I'll try to wrap up these videos in like 10 minutes. And then after I do that, I'll go into actually going into some teaching and running it like a class. But essentially, since we're asynchronous, I try to just lay out the instructions in a short, brief Zoom meeting. So modules are located under content. And the first module is right here, module 1. Sebastian has a pretest in here, and you can take that pretest to get started. We won't use it to evaluate you. We just use it for these OPAL assessment meetings that I have, and they're just teaching fundamentals, how they measure whether or not the course is working. Module 1, okay, here's the instructions. It's on chapters 1 through 3. You know, we're going to work with the interface, options, templates, basic modeling. And then as we go through and we start to work with it, these are the 3 parts that we're going to do first. And so I've got those open on my screen over here. And I really like teaching. I really like answering questions, provided I have, you know, some understanding of what's going on with it. So after I do the 10 minute, if you guys want to stick around and go through just detailing and things like that, I'm all for it. And so here's the first part that we'll model. And then I've got the other parts in here. Here's the second part. I'm not sure what my computer's doing. It's glitching. Sorry, it's back. And so as we go through these models, I have all the information that you need to get started. Here's the textbook for chapter 3. Here's the chapter 1 video. And the videos were done by Sebastian. Sebastian's great. He's a design engineer, works in the field. I've been teaching the SolidWorks course as well as he has, and it's just falling into my responsibility this semester. But you'll probably see Sebastian in some of the upper level SolidWorks courses if you decide to pursue those. I have to let one more person into the room. If you get stuck out there, instant message me or make some noise to let me know. So the videos are all set up. And so we have a video for each of the assignments. And so if we look at, let's say, video lab 1A, we go through and everything is laid out for you, as well as some tips and tricks. Sebastian does a really nice job at this. Laying out the geometry. And this is a much better way to learn CAD than reading through all the textbooks, I think. All right, back to the module 1. And then, so we have a video for the construction of each one of these. You can pause it, stop it. And then what you'll do after you can complete the model is you'll do the multiple choice quiz. And so we have a multiple choice quiz, and there's two quizzes at the end of each module. This one right here will ask you questions about the chapters. It's worth 7 points. I'm not sure if it'll let me see it. Let's see if I can preview it. Yeah, so how do you get to the general options? You can create a template that can be used for other projects. And then you just go through and you answer these, whether they're true or false, and then you submit them. If you have a glitch, if something comes up, you can request a retake, but essentially do the best you can with that. And then let me come back here. It won't let me out. Let me submit my quiz. Yeah. So I've gotten bad grades before. Some people never have. Back to the exam under content. I just didn't take school that seriously when I was younger. All right, so you'll take the quizzes for the multiple choice. The volume quiz is basically going to ask you the volume of each of the part models. And it's really quite good because it's how we do things if you decide to get certified. So if I start this quiz, what is the volume of Lab A? What is the volume of Lab 1B? And what is the volume of 1C? And I'll check these to make sure that the units and measurements are correct. But essentially, if I come back to mine, right here. Get out of this. Starting off in the hole. It'll let you know that you've submitted it and it'll record that. And then if I go into SolidWorks, to be able to evaluate these models, we go into the Evaluate tab and we can go to the mass properties. And so I can see what my volume is, cubic inches. All right. So basically, we're going to go through SolidWorks in the first 10 modules. I've left them all on so that you can kind of go through it. We follow the book sequentially. So as we look at module 2, we'll be working with extrusions, revolve, and more drafting and modeling. I put bonus labs in a lot. I like to put the bonus labs to give people an opportunity to do more work. I really like to draft and I like to work on the computer. Typically I'll have the computer on or the TV and I'll go through some of these things. I like, just going through these sketches. So I've included them, but they're not required. And I've also got some videos for how to create those videos. And so if you go to my video, I've got somebody who's texting. Get rid of that. And I realize I'm going a little quick here, but essentially there's quite a bit of content. And so there's always more work if you want it. But on the other end, I also know that people are quite busy. So the course is laid out. We typically cover 10 to 12 modules. And so typically we'll go all the way up to 12. And then I have a couple other modules here that we can bring in if we need to. Textbook will be SolidWorks Basics. You can get that on Amazon or on Google Books. And every week we'll cover a different chapter. Submit your assignments to the assignments folder and they will be graded. If I take a look at the rubrics for that, let me just go and submit one. So I'll go to assignments and let me switch over to a student so you can see this. And we'll go to assignments. And we'll go to module one Dropbox. You'll be graded on setup and configuration, proper units, plane initialization, sketching, is the geometry accurate, general features, extrusions, revolves. Each chapter covers a different feature. And so I can give you feedback and this is how you'll be graded for the course. You can also submit files here. So I can, you know, here is my module one assignment. Look at the fillets. I can't figure out blah, blah, blah. So you can submit things and put them in there and now I'll see them and I'll be able to help you. So if you're working at 2 o'clock in the morning and you throw something in there, I get on the computer in the morning, I can help you troubleshoot those. And then what I would do is I would add the file. You know, you're welcome to record an audio or a video. I haven't gotten anybody who's done that yet. We'll see. Go to my computer, upload. And then I'll just grab a SolidWorks file from my desktop. And so I just grab this one, open, add it, submit. And then once you submit it, you'll get a notification that tells you, you know, it has been submitted. I guess mine hasn't popped off there yet, but it will. All right, back to viewing as an instructor. And that's the basic course layout. There's a 3D printing project in here that's kind of neat. I have it as a bonus. And so we were doing these, let's see, here it is. These vices. I may switch that up a little bit to make some other things, but I really enjoy the 3D printing. So if anybody's interested in learning about that, I have a CAD 107 course and SolidWorks very well with that. And so here's my message, D2L notification submission receipt. All right, so I've kind of gone over my limit. I'm going to stop this recording and post it. If you do have any questions or concerns, you can always email me or instant message. All right, that ends this recording. I'm going to stop the recording and open things up for questions.